In this lecture, we are going to discuss Venn diagram. Now, what is a Venn diagram? According to this slide, it is a diagram that shows all possible logical relations between finite collection of different sets. Now, the keyword that we have to remember here is this one. It's a relation. Now, when we say relation, this is in connection with this illustration. Pag sinabi natin Venn diagram, it pertains to a specific illustration. Alright? Now, the illustration here about Venn diagram is these circles. Okay, ang sabi dito, it's a relation between collection of different sets. Now, when we say sets here, ito yung isang bilog. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, we're talking about relationship of these different sets. Now, in Venn diagram, this is called union. Union yung tinutukoy dito sa relations. Okay? Now, the sets that we are talking about here is if we are to describe a certain variable. Let's say if we're going to discuss an orange that's a variable, what are the properties that can be found in that specific set? Okay? Yun yung ibig sabihin ng set. So, ibig sabihin, if we have an orange here, isang orange yan, and then dun sa loob ng set is are groups or pwedeng series of properties that would describe the orange. Okay, that is, now the reason why we have to put a circle here for the orange is to describe the orange exclusively in contrast with other sets. If we're going to compare an orange, for instance, with an apple, nakikita natin yung difference of properties. Kasi nakikita natin dito mismo sa loob ng set kung anong property ang meron sa orange at saka dito sa apple. Kasi sa apple, we're going to put all the properties exclusive of the apple here inside the set. Okay, again, that's the set. Yun ang tinutukoy dun sa set. Ang keyword that we have to remember under Venn diagram is it's all about relationships. Relationships of sets. Now, these diagrams depict elements. Yung elements that is being described here are your properties. These elements as points in the plane and sets as regions inside closed curves. Venn diagram consists of multiple overlapping closed curves. Nag-overlap siya. Ito yung ibig sabihin ng overlap. Let me just erase these lines again. Ito yung overlap na tinutukoy dyan. Okay? When I say, now, the reason why it's necessary to analyze yung pag-overlap ng circle with another circle, ang indication niyan is may common property present dito, for example, sa variable A tsaka sa variable B. Although they have exclusive properties, yung orange, for example, yung pagiging orange niya dito, yung apple, yung pagiging red niya, they share the same properties. And question, under Venn diagram, we are going to discover that. Alright, that's, yun yung ibig sabihin ng overlapping closed curves. Usually circles, each representing a set. Okay? Three keywords. Relations, nag-overlap, tapos sets. Okay, the relationship, ito yung pag-intersect ng circle with another circle and then with another circle. Now, we have three circles here. In Venn diagram, we call that three sets. The sets that is being described here is are your properties exclusive with a certain variable, or these are also properties that are shared by two variables. Okay, nag-overlap, ibig sabihin nun, they share a common property. Alright, that's an overview about Venn diagram. Now, we have to remember some terms dito sa subsequent slides that we're going to discuss. Under Venn diagram, these are important terms that you should remember. Set and elements. Union, which is best represented by the small letter U. Intersection, ibig sabihin nag-i-intersect yung isang set with another set. That's intersection. And then difference, ibig sabihin ng difference, we have to know the distinctive property na meron lang sa isang set in contrast with another set. Okay, we do that by removing some properties. Kaya we use the symbol na minus under difference. And then we have 3 sets. Pag 3 sets, ibig sabihin yan, meron tayong tatlong circles. And then we have an empty set. Pag sinabi nating empty set, let's say we have 3 circles here na nag-intersect. And then assuming this particular area here is already known, this particular area here is already known, this particular area here is already known. Ang tanong, if this area is unknown, it is called an empty set. Okay, kasi it's still an area within the set, but it is empty. When you say empty, walang variable present inside that specific area. For universal set, in contrast with the word union, huwag kayong malito, pag sinabi natin union, tapos universal set, pareha silang letter U. But for union, it is best represented by a small letter U. For the universal set, it is best represented by a big letter U. Alright? And then for complement, ang sa universal set pala, may makikita tayong isang square. Tapos doon natin makikita yung set. Tapos may variable tayong makikita dito sa isang set, another variable dito sa isang set, and then another variable outside the mention sets. Okay, ibig sabihin when we say universal, lahat. Lahat kasama doon yung variables na hindi natin makikita sa isang set. Like this variable, which is the variable C. Alright, that's a universal set. For complement, ang complement in contrast with letter I, we're going to discuss that in the subsequent slides. Ang complement lang, since letter E yan, it pertains to a variable na nagkukumpleto sa isang variable. Okay? So, ibig sabihin nun, yung variable C, pag sinabi natin variable C dito, pag nilagay natin, it is best represented by a small variable C. These are properties that are exclusive lang dito sa letter A. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, yung properties na yun, yun yung nagkukumpleto sa pagiging variable A niya. Kaya siya tinawag na complement. Meaning to say, these properties which are exclusive in variable A, hindi natin siya makikita dito sa variable B or sa variable C. Kasi itong properties na present lang sa variable A, siya yung nagko-complement dun sa variable A, kaya siya tinawag na variable A. Right? Let's proceed. Let's discuss set and elements. Now, let's have this example in front of us. We have 2 variables, a banana and a lemon. Now, let's say that the banana is your variable A and then yung lemon is your variable B. Alright? So, meaning to say, there are exclusive properties present in variable A that are not present in your variable B. And what are those properties? These are the properties of being smooth and sweet. Okay? These properties here, smooth, sweet, yellow, and fruit, can be written inside curly brackets. Now, ano yung curly brackets? Ito yung curly brackets na makikita natin dito. It is like this one. Kaya siya tinawag na curly brackets. Now, 4 elements in the mention set. Now, we can find 4 elements inside this curly brackets. Now, what are those 4 elements? We have smooth, yellow, sweet, and fruit. So, meaning to say, these properties are properties that can be found in your variable A, which is your banana. Curly brackets imply properties, members present in a sample variable. So, ibig sabihin, itong set na to, yung properties na makikita natin sa loob ng curly brackets, these are called elements. Each property in the curly bracket is an element or member of the set. So, pag sinaran natin yan, yung curly bracket, pag naging dalawang bracket na yan, isang bracket dito, tapos isang bracket na magsasara, that is called a set. So, yung isang set na yun, pwede nating drawingan na isang circuit. Okay, so ibig sabihin dun sa loob ng circle na yun, makikita natin yung four elements that we put inside the curly bracket, which are the following: the smooth, ito, smooth, yellow, fruit, and pagiging sweet. Alright? Now, if we're going to put another curly bracket and describe lemon, gagawa ulit tayo ng curly bracket. Okay, pwedeng lagyan natin ng curly bracket dito. Tapos, sour, bumpy, yellow, and then yung pagiging fruit niya. So, if you can notice, there are two variables, or there are two elements or properties that are common between banana and lemon, between variables A and B. And what are those? Makikita natin dito, it's the yellow. Merong yellow dito. And then, meron ding yellow dito sa lemon. Meron ding fruit. And then, meron ding fruit dito sa banana. So, ang exclusive property lang that we can see for the lemon or variable B is the letter S, which means sour, and then the letter B, which means bumpy. So, these two common properties that are being shared by the banana and then lemon, dito natin siya ilalagay sa gitna, sa intersecting area, intersecting set. Why? Because, now the reason why we have to put it here in the middle, it's because these properties are shared, or these properties are common between these two variables. Okay, that's why we put them inside this intersecting area. Okay, so makikita natin yun through this diagram, through this illustration, we can easily see these properties or those properties that are common dun sa binigay nating variable na banana and lemon. So, we can use Venn diagram in our reporting, in our thesis proposal, in our thesis or ano pang proposal in our future level sa college. Now, ang Venn diagram is also used for civil service exam, and then probably in your employment exam. Okay, that's why I try to remember the technique that we're going to discuss in this slide. Okay, punta tayo sa next slide. Now, that's ang tinukoy natin dito sa slide na to, yung pagsusulat ng brackets, and then yung pagre-representa ng brackets na yun, yung mga properties na yun, dito sa Venn diagram, dito sa circles. And then because of that, you are able to determine those two common variables present in the given variables. Two common properties in the given variables. Next tayo. Now, let's say we have 10 best friends. Okay, persons sa to. Now, let's say we have 10 best friends. And then these best friends, pwede natin siyang ilagay sa curly brackets. And so from Alex to Jade. Now let's say that 4 out of 10 best friends play soccer. So sino yung best friends na yun? Pwede natin siyang ilagay dito sa word na soccer, and then equal sign, and then curly brackets dito. Tapos from Alex, Casey, Drew, and Hunter. Okay, so ibig sabihin na hiwalay na natin yung apat na best friend dun sa 6 friends. Now, let's say we have 3 of the 10 best friends play tennis. So, same application pa rin. We have the word tennis, equal sign, and then curly brackets, Casey, Drew, and Jade. Now, if you can notice, merong intersecting line kaagad kasi si Casey at saka si Casey present sa tennis at saka sa soccer. Meron pa bang present sa soccer? Dito sa tennis, si Casey. Let's check si Drew. Si Drew meron din. Si Drew tsaka si Drew. Si Jade wala. Okay, so ibig sabihin, of the 10 best friends, may common property or common element na present dun sa soccer tsaka sa tennis. Sino yun? Si Drew? Si Casey? Si Drew tsaka si Casey lang. Alright? that's the importance of putting first the elements inside the curly brackets. So we have, let's put those elements now inside the Venn diagram. So if we're going to put those elements inside the Venn diagram, ang appearance na magiging ganito. So circle, ito yung soccer, ito yung tennis, si Alex, si Casey, si Drew, si Hunter, si Casey, si Drew, saka si Jay. Now, this is just a circle, hindi pa siya Venn diagram kasi hindi pa siya nagkakaroon ng intersection. Now, this is just for analysis first. Now, kung magkakaroon na siya ng intersection, intersection ibig sabihin, if we're going to compare intersection with union, ang pagdating sa intersection nito, okay, sa ibig sabihin ng intersection yung tinutukoy natin dito sa gitna. Right, so don't get confused if we're going to compare intersection with union. Okay? So punta muna tayo dito sa union. Now when we say union, it says it's the combination. So it's an act of putting those two circles together. So when we say union again, pag pinagsama na natin yung dalawang bilog na pinag-usapan natin from our preceding slide. So combination of elements of the two sets. So if you try to combine the two sets, when you say yung two sets, ang tinutukoy natin dito yung isang set na to, tapos isang set na to, nag-union sila. Alright? Parang sa Dragon Ball Z, yung fusion. Nagsama na yung soccer tsaka tennis. So kung magsasama na yung soccer tsaka tennis, magkakaroon ng intersecting area dito. Okay, yun yung next term na i-discuss natin sa next slide. So punta muna tayo dito sa union. Again, ang union, tandaan natin yung Dragon Ball, yung pagsanib puwersa ng dalawang element, ng dalawang sets. Right? Union represented is union is best represented by the symbol small letter U. Ito pa rin yung given variable from our previous slide. We have 4 of 10 friends who are playing soccer. So si Alex, si Casey, si Drew, present siya rito. And then 10 is si Casey, si Drew, and si Jade. Now the reason why we have to put Casey and Drew in the middle is because si Casey, eto si Casey, makikita rin natin dito sa soccer. So ibig sabihin si Casey naglalaro ng tennis, si Casey naglalaro ng soccer. Alright? Or Drew, ganun din. Si Drew naglalaro ng tennis, si Drew naglalaro ng soccer. That's why we have to put it here in the middle. After uniting the two sets. Now, after uniting them, you call that union, nagkakaroon na tayo ng intersection ito. So, before we proceed to this one, let's apply numbers to union. Now, let's check this example and then if you want, you can pause this video and try in your end if we have the same answer. Right? So, A, set A is united or in union with set B. So, ibig sabihin, yung set A, eto, kailangan natin ipagsama sa set B. If we have set A na 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and then B na 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, ano ngayon ang lalabas dito sa intersecting area? Okay, check muna natin. Meron ba tayong number 2 sa letter B? Meron. So kung meron tayong 2, it is present in B, sa natin siya ilalagay? In the middle. So we have to put number 2 here in the middle kasi present siya sa variable A and present siya sa variable B. Tanggalin natin yung 2, tanggalin natin yung 2. How about 4? Meron bang 4? Merong 4. Tanggalin natin yung 4, tanggalin natin yung 4, ilagay natin dito yung 4. How about 6? Wala. Kung wala ang 6 na natin ilalagay, it's exclusive lang dito sa 8. 8. Meron bang 8 sa variable B? Wala. So ilagay ulit natin dito yung number 8. How about number 10? Wala din. So, ilagay natin dito yung 10. So after ito union of letter A and B, itong elements ang lalabas yun sa Venn diagram, magiging ganito for letter A pa lang. So for letter B, check natin, ang natitira is 1, 3, and 5. Alright? So, if you can see this, for instance, in the exam, itong illustration na to na Venn diagram, ang tinatanong ko dito is, for example, ang tinatanong ko dito is the intersecting area. What are the intersecting area? Ang magiging options natin ay ito. Or meron pang isang letter, third option. Okay, ang reason lang ba't natin kailangan gawin to is for you to have an interpretation of how to put these variables na nasa bracket dito sa Venn diagram. Okay, ang confusing lang dito yung common element. Ang common element dito is the number 2, number 4, meron pa ba? Number 6, wala. Number 8, wala. Number 10, wala. So, we have 2 and 4. Tama ba? 2, 4, 6, wala. 8, wala. 10, wala. 5. Okay. Ang pinaka-objective of this slide is for you to remember and for you to determine how to put variables, how to put properties or elements dito sa intersecting area. Para makita nyo yung elements na exclusive lang sa variable A and variable B. Okay, we do that by union. Alright, that's for the union. Now, we go to intersection.